Yo, guys, welcome back to a brand new PDCGL Brilliant Stars video. Today, guys, we're going to be taking a look at the brand new Aggron VMAX today. This card is actually a beast. It's got two attacks, it's got 330 HP, and it works with the new double turbo energy, which makes it pretty cool and solid overall. It's got the attack Crocking Stomp, which does 150 damage. You discard the top card of your opponent's deck. Nothing too special, but it's a nice solid damage output attack. With Choice Belt, you're able to two-shot VMAX Pokemon if you have a choice, you know, if you already have the double turbo energy on it. And then you have GMAX Takedown, which if you can build up 5 energy, which is not too hard to do, as I am going to be pairing Aggron with Arceus V-Star, of course, we can actually use Max Takedown for 270 damage with a Choice Belt. Leon, we can actually one-hit KO other VMAX Pokemon, which is a really cool kind of thing that we have going for us in this deck. It is going to be an Arceus Metal-type deck. We got Zacian in the deck, we got the new Zamazenta V, and we even got Bronzong in the deck for energy acceleration. Honestly, this was a pretty fine deck to play. Arceus being able to build up your energy with Trini Nova basically is like the new way to kind of play V's right now. So we're going to use Trini Nova, build up energy, especially for something like Aggron that needs 5 energy to attack. And then, of course, with the ability to use Bronzong to move the energy around, we have ourselves a pretty sick combo here. So if you're in the video, of course, shout out to the sponsor, CardCaverns TCG. As always, guys, if you're ever looking for any PDCGO codes, make sure to go get them over at CardCaverns. If you're looking to get any Brilliant Stars codes, make sure to get the Brilliant Stars codes over at CardCaverns. Or if you're looking for older sets, of course, like a cheaper set like Celebrations for Pokemon TCG Live, get them over at CardCaverns. If you get any codes at CardCaverns at the checkout, use my discount code, CodeLDF, for a 5% discount on your order. Help the channel, help yourself out, and help out CardCaverns. So shout out to CardCaverns, check them out, use code LDF. All right, now let's take a look at the Aggron deck I've got here. So I think this is the best way to play Aggron was with Arceus and Bronzong, and because it complements so well. Being able to build up that much energy with Arceus for your Aggron is really good. And there's a lot of cool support Pokemon in the deck, like Zacian V, which is good. We have the new Zamazenta. We got Lumineon and Crobat in the deck. I will say, what am I playing in Eldegoss in here? Because there are some important one of supporters, mainly Leon and Cheryl. Leon, again, will help you push for those one-hit KO options with Aggron, but also sometimes lets you do like cheeky plays with Trini Nova against some V Pokemon. So there's some cool combos there, but Leon is good for the Aggron to do 330 damage. But there's also Cheryl, which of course we can use with Bronzong to kind of move the energy off Aggron and then Cheryl and fully heal it, which is really good. And when we have access to Lumineon and Arceus V-Star, it's honestly not hard to kind of, you know, play the Cheryl when we need to. So really like Cheryl in here, because not only does he heal Aggron, he can also heal the Arceus, but two Cheryls might actually be better than one, and this is why I want to play Eldegoss in the deck, but there's slim pickings, because we also want to play some Metal Saucers for a bit of extra energy excel. We got Crystal Cave, we need to play, you know, a counter stadium to Path, and Cave is obviously the best one to play. We also got to play, you know, everything else, like Pokemon Search Cards, want some Switch. Aggron does have a hefty retreat cost of 4, it is a thick Pokemon, so we do want to play Swim Switch to move it around. Choice Belt, obviously, for the extra damage. I got 3 Double Turbos and 8 Metal. I think that's a pretty safe amount of energy, honestly, with Metal Saucer, Trini Nova. Not too hard to get energy in play. I think 11 energy is a pretty good amount of energy. I found that the 11 energy was quite literally perfect for this deck. I had no issues with having that many energy in the deck as opposed to maybe like 4 double turbos. But yeah, the deck was pretty fine all around. I think it's a really cool deck. I think Aggron is quite a beast, and it might be worth trying out, especially because it does combo pretty well with double turbo energy. So let's go try it out on PCGO and see in action, see what we can do with the deck. All right, looks like we're going to go second here, which is fine. As long as our start's not too bad. We open up Zacian, which we'll have to do for now. Hopefully we can draw an Arceus here. That'd be pretty good. We'll see, though. All right, we see a Raikou get flipped over. Okay. They're playing a Lightning Box deck. All right, cool. That's not good, though. They might have Raichu, which can Oko me, which could be bad. I mean, I could have a turn 2 Brave Blade, though. Let's see what we draw. Marnie? We'll just play it. I mean, their hand's massive. We're obviously Marnieing them there. All right. Arceus, Bronzor, something like that. Okay, cool. So I'm a quick ball here. Wait, Ultra Ball. Grab Arceus. And then hope and pray. Well, they're not going to KO me, obviously. It was Intrepid Sword. No energy. Yikes. We drew some cards I didn't like either. Not my Aggron, bro. Not the Aggron. That's fine. We'll make it work. We'll make work with it. No energy, though. I can't knock out the Raikou with Brave Blade, unfortunately. But with Choice Belt, I can kill the Raikou with Arceus, which we'll have to do. They got 2 Raikous. Are they just playing a straight Raikou deck? Raikou's not as good as Entei or Suicune, in my opinion. So I don't know. I imagine they're playing like Raichu or Rayquaza or something. We'll see, though. I don't know. I don't think Raikou does well by itself. Okay. We'll see what we draw here. Perfect. That's good. Shuffle the deck. Balloon. Cave. Heal. Grab Arceus. And hopefully they make my life easy and I can just get double turbo choice belt off this, but I doubt it. But I need... Ooh. No, I can't attack with Arceus this turn because I still need Bronzong. I completely forgot I need Bronzong still. Whoops. Yeah, I forgot about Bronzong. Ooh, my bad. And I actually drew the choice belt too. No. Okay, that's fine. We're going to get KO'd. I don't want to lose my Zacian. Actually, fine. Arceus already KOs. Yeah, actually, I don't really care if we get if Zacian gets KO'd, actually. That's fine. It's cool. What is Intrepid Sword? We'll let him knock out Zacian. I'm fine with it getting knocked out. Well, yeah, that's fine. Because, like, Arceus can one-shot the Raikou anyways, right? So it's not a big deal. But actually, giving up two prizes, though, is kind of sus. Oh, they're playing Pikachu v. Union. Oh, how much HP does that have? I can't tell. I think it's got 300 HP, though, which is good for Aggron. Okay, I should have just gave him Bronzor. Giving them two prizes is actually kind of a sus play. No, I should have just went to Bronzor. But I didn't have another one. Yeah, whatever. I didn't want to go into Arceus or Aggron, obviously. We have the ability to do Cheryl, though. And we don't have the Starbirth this turn, which makes it even easier. All right, that's fine. I don't really mind them knocking me out there. Kind of sucks, but it's not the end of the world. Okay. Attach. Choice spell. Do that. Do that. Do that. And what else? When am I getting the VMAX down this turn? I think I'm going to keep Zam, though. I don't really want to lose Bronzor, though, but whatever. Sorry, Bronzor, buddy. I mean, we only have one Bronze on this game, but if they knock it out, I mean, it's not really doing much for my opponent. Okay, that was a really bad Crobat. Well, not a bad Crobat per se, but kind of a sus one. They can't one-shot me, right? I guess I could go Pikachu V-Union, but with only one Flaffy in play, that's so unlikely. So let's just... I'll just knock him out. We don't need to do anything this turn, I don't think. I'm fine with just not getting much. And they'll put three on Aggron. We'll put one on the Arceus. On the off chance, they boss KO me, which I don't think will happen, but you never know. All right, choice belt. Aggron. Okay. What does Aggron V do again? 150 if your opponent already has damage on it. Does 300 damage, bro, for 5 energy? Broken attack, bro. Yeah, pretty sure Pikachu has 300 HP. It doesn't have resistance, which is good. So I'm pretty sure we can one-shot it with Aggron choice belt if all goes well. At this point, we just win with Arceus alone, though, because we don't even need the Aggron. Yeah, as long as we don't get KO'd here, I can just go Starbirth. And I can go into Aggron VMAX this turn if I really wanted to, which I'm tempted to do. But Pikachu VMAX can do 250. Even with a choice belt, Aggron's not getting KO'd, right? I don't want to do Starbirth, though, for the Aggron. I need to get Cheryl with Starbirth. I don't have Lumineon anymore, right? Cheryl's going to be pretty good for Aggron here, so I don't know. But I think I do want to go Aggron VMAX, obviously, this turn to just kind of wall a hit. Or I can go another Arceus, which is probably good, too, to be honest. If I go Aggron, though, I get the ability to Cheryl my Arceus, though. That's the thing, though. I can heal both of them if they don't get bossed. And they are down one boss now with that research. All right, let's see how they're going to get Pikachu in play. They've got two pieces in the discard, so they'll eventually get there. Yeah, I guess Raikou Pikachu's a decent deck. I kind of underestimated that idea. Ooh, they have a cape. Well, we definitely have to go Aggron now. Good thing it was all part of the plan, bro. It was all part of the plan. Now they're bench locked. Well, that doesn't really matter. Ooh, they play Tool Scrapper. Ooh, that's spicy. That's fine. All right, do they have anything else? Just a Lightning Rondo for 200. Okay. Let's see what we draw. Switch. That's a pretty good draw. I'm going to have to waste my Starbirth here. Do I have Cheryl? I should. Yeah, it's in there. Not ideal to kind of burn my own V power, but whatever. Now, the question of the day is... Go Evo Incense, actually. Question of the day is, do I go grab a Research or a Marnie? Marnie isn't terrible. I don't want to give them a boss, though. I don't want them to boss my Arceus. That would be really annoying. I think he's gonna KO this to win, which is like actually pretty easy to do. Like we could lose if they boss my Arceus here. And actually, it's fine if they do that. So I'm gonna go Marnie and just try to protect my resources. Grab Aggron. Because we're trying to set up the Cheryl, right? So might as well just go Aggron. Fine. I'm gonna retreat. Keep the switch. And then we'll move the energy here. For the choice belt. And then Marnie. And then we're just going to try to draw into Cheryl that way. I don't know. I don't want to research away that hand. I want to keep the Zamazenta around. I also don't want to bench it because I don't want to fuel Lightning Rondo. We got Cheryl. Perfect. We also got off too. If they bench Pikachu, I could just knock that out. All right, G-Max takedown. We're not going to get killed in return. We have 300 HP. I'm pretty sure they can't do 300 damage. Like, I'm pretty confident they're not going to be able to do 300 damage. So we'll see. We'll take our prizes. But yeah, I don't know how they're going to stop the Aggron at this point. It's quite a beast. I mean, it's a pretty linear kind of strategy. You know, Arceus did most of the work. But as you can see, they can't defeat Aggron. And I mean, I don't know how they're going to stop a 300 HP Aggron that also has a Cheryl coming their way. So we can Cheryl next turn, heal the Arceus and the Aggron, which is super good for us, especially when Raikou can't kill me. So they have to try to boss my Arceus this turn. But even that's not a good play because then I just win. So I'm pretty sure we just win no matter what. As long as they literally cannot do a knockout here, we're chilling. I kind of want them to put the Pikachu in play this turn just so I can boss KO with Aggron. That'd be pretty epic. But yeah, they can't stop me. Aggron is invincible. Not actually, but it's pretty beastly. A pretty beastly Pokemon. Let's see if they can stop it here. They do have the boss. All right, well, I guess they're going to get a prize after all. I was hoping they would hit the Aggron, but game anyways. I don't think they're going to put Pikachu in play this turn. Oh, maybe. They got Level Ball. They can change Chinchino. I want them to play down the Pikachu this turn just so that I can take a one-shot on it with Aggron VMAX, but it's all good. Kind of wanted to do that, though. I don't think they're going to get Pikachu down this turn. Rip. Dang it, I wanted to KO. But anyways, that's game anyways. Aggron just completely bodies the Raikou. That's what it's all about. Kind of a close game, actually, to be honest. It's because we let that Zacian get KO'd. But whatever, it's fine. We just max takedown again, knock him out. A little bit of an Aggron sweep here at the end. What a beast. Actually, I really like their deck. Raikou with Pikachu V-Union actually makes a lot of sense. It's kind of like the Suicune Greninja V-Union deck, but instead of Suicune, you have Raikou. So, I don't know. Definitely, I like the deck. I'm going to definitely look into making a video on it. All right, we're up against a dark deck here. We're going second. Our hand's pretty good. Going first, this hand would have been pretty bonkers, though, but yeah, this hand would have been great going first. Fine. Morpeko. I think it's a single prize deck. All right, we'll see if we can beat it. Capture energy? So we want a Trinity Charge here. Build up Aggron. Probably going to have to Ultra Ball the V-Star way, too. Well, we'll see what we're playing against. Yeah, let's get rid of the V-Star. Fine. Do we have our other one? Yeah, we do. We're fine. Get a Bronzor. And then we're going to hope to find the Turbo Energy here. We can go for the Aggron. Do I get the Turbo? I get nothing. I can Crobat for it. I'll have to do. Damn, that was a big whiff. All right, well, whatever. How much I can do about that? All right, Crobat for 4. Can I find the double turbo? I do. Perfect. We got double evil incense, which is pretty ballin' too. All right, not bad, not bad. We can build up Aggron here. And I can go for the Aggron attack and then try to Cheryl heal it at some point. Especially if I can save my Starbirth. I don't think I'm going to be able to save Starbirth, though, unfortunately. There's probably attack with Arceus V-Star. Let it take a hit and then go into the Aggron. And then that takes a hit and then I Cheryl both of them. That might have to be the play. At least we got the double turbo. No follow-up supporter. A little sussy-wussy, but not a big deal. Okay, well, now I'm not going Arceus V-Star. Ooh, but they have a Marnie. There goes my double evil Incense. That sucks. That was a good hand. Hopefully we don't draw poorly here. It'd be pretty bad if we did, and we don't. We have at least the VMAX. I get it, an Arceus V-Star, though. It's not a great hand, but it's not the end of the world. They do play Stonjourner. Good thing they don't attack me with it. All right, they're only doing 100 damage. It's barely anything. Well, that's actually quite a bit of damage. All right, let's see what we draw. Perfect. I'd like to see. We'll go Aggron here. Retreat. Not a fan of losing the Crystal Cave, though, but whatever. research. I'm not going to bother Zam this matchup. And what do we get? Another double turbo. I can get Bronzong here. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Hopefully they're not playing Urshifu VMAX, but I'm going to get Bronzong. Could go Arceus V-Star, actually. They might boss. No, we'll go Arceus. Yeah, no. We never go Bronzong. Going Bronzong makes no sense. In that scenario, anyways. And then I'm going to just knock him out. I don't really need to do anything else, I don't think. Then next turn, I can go Starbirth for the Cheryl play, right? So I'm not going to hold off on the double turbo. Just take a KO here. Mill the top card. Could be relevant. Could hit an urn or something. We hit a VIP. The worst card we could have hit. A battle VIP pass. Oh my god. My other game plan in this match is to set up another Aggron. We're just going to try to make it hard for them to win by not getting them any prize outs. If they knock out my Arceus here, though, that might be a little awkward, but won't really be that big of a deal if they do knock it out. But we're just going to like make it hard for them to take KOs. We're going to set up like double Aggron and stuff. Can I do that? Yeah, I can. We're going to make him go through two Aggron VMAXs and an Arceus. Ooh, they have Marnie. I don't like that hand because I was going to bench Aggron and then switch into it. All right. Now we can Starbirth for Cheryl and something else. That's good. How much are they doing? 80 damage. Can they two-shot me? No, not with Crystal Cave. We have two. No, there's no way they're doing 280 damage. We should be safe. Hopefully we're safe. Jeez. All right, let's get the big bell guy here. And then I can boss. Knock out Houndoom, which is honestly not terrible. Knock out Houndoom, take a hit, and then Cheryl. Sure, let's do it. Let's do it. Crack and stomp. Mill that top. Please don't be another VIP pass. Okay, nice. We hit an urn. That's a really good discard. That's what I was hoping for, is we maybe hit an urn of vitality. Probably get a quick ball for an Aggron V, actually, but we can do that next turn. Because we're probably going to go Starbirth for research plus Cheryl. And then we're going to Cheryl, as long as they don't take a prize, which I don't think they can. Well played. They scoop. All right, we got him. And again, if they hit me hard there, I was going to go Cheryl the Aggron and then Cracking Stomp and get another Aggron established. And we could have just probably checkmated them that way. But yeah, no, Aggron's a beast. Ooh, losing the coin flip doesn't feel great. But we can always go with a turn one Arceus V, so maybe that'll work out for us. Not with this hand, though. We got, like, nothing in our hand. Not even, like, Zamazenta or anything. Or Zacian. Not good. I think it's Inteleon. An Inteleon deck, anyways. Yeah. We have Manaphy. They're playing Jolteon or the Big Bad Bear. Haha, we got Manaphy. But the problem is I am bricking, so I don't know. We might not have a lot of time on the clock. Okay, they're playing Rapshack Inteleon. Oh, that means they have Cheryl, which is going to make this very awkward. But I can try to one-hit KO with Aggron. So maybe it's not too bad. But I got to keep my Leon then. Okay. That was a good top deck. I got a Marnie, unfortunately. Not unfortunately, but not what I really wanted to do. It's fine. We'll just hide here. All right, Marnie, let's get it. Can we please get something good? AK, Zacian, something. Okay, nice. Good hand, good hand. Kind of want to get Arceus here, though, actually, instead of Zacian. But I got a V-Star, so I got to follow up with a Zacian, which is fine. Or I could just go Zamazenta. Yeah, no, Zam's is better here, right? Yeah, why would I just not go Zam? Literally 10 times better. Regal Stance. Let's get it, bro. My first time using the ability. Okay, pretty solid hand. Do I have an energy in the discard? I do. Okay, cool. I could do a Cracking Stomp next turn. I think I'm going to do. I'm going to Cracking Stomp next turn if they don't Marnie me. They could. Marnie in a Regal Stance doesn't really feel great, though. I don't know. All right, don't Marnie me, please. That'd be great. All right, let's see what they got here. They got the Inteleon, the Drizzle. Hopefully they don't attack me. Because, like, I guess Lumineon's kind of squishy. They could hit it for 140 and then, like, knock it out easily down the road. So, might be sus. But they do have to find the VMAX and the Rapidstrike energy. And they probably want a drop support or two. So, I don't know if they'll find all that. Please don't Marnie me. My hand is really, really good. They Marnie me and go double turbo energy, I guess, which isn't terrible. Cracking Stomp could be good. Maybe I Cracking Stomp get lucky and hit, like, good cards. Okay, they're going to research. All right. Ooh, they play Path. That could be annoying. I don't have Starbirth, which could be relevant if we ever need to find Cheryl or Leon. Speaking of Cheryl, they are down a Cheryl and an Inteleon, which is honestly pretty solid. Yeah, they got it. All right, well, here's the thing, though. They hit me here, assuming they don't whip the energy. They hit me. Then I can go Marnie. That's still a good play, actually, for me. I'm still in a good spot. Thankfully, they didn't... They did not Marnie me. I do need to get the Aggron VMAX, though. Still need Aggron, I guess. But I could always fall back on Zamazenta. I don't really want to do, but I might have to do. Would have been a scenario where having Arceus would have been good. Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. Hopefully, it all works out. If I go Zam, I go Zam. As long as I can two-shot this, right? Okay, we got the Aggron. I did get Crystal Cave, so... I'm going to have to save that for next turn. Plus, I don't want to give them their ability. Yeah, I can hold the hand for a turn and then go Crobat. Or we get Marnied again, right? Cracking Stomp. Let's hit a Rapid Energy or a Sobble. Or no, or a Cheryl, sorry. Hey, let's go. We actually hit a Cheryl. All right, cool. Nice. Maybe they prize a Cheryl or prize both other Cheryls. That's good. Now, they need to attack me this turn too, which maybe they can't do, maybe. We have a lot of HP, though, so, I mean, them doing 140 isn't really that big of a deal. They could be playing Choice Belt now, which I guess would make things worse, but thanks to Crystal Cave, we could just keep spamming Cracking Stomp, right, and then just set up the Cheryl. They could boss my Bronzong. I do need another Bronzong in play, so I'm going to try to keep this hand, though, if I can, or at least keep the Bronzong around. I don't want to lose my Bronzong to a boss here. So if they have a boss, I feel like they'd maybe go after Arceus or Lumineon, which isn't even terrible, considering I have a 4-card hand. What do they do? I need to keep my Crystal Cave, though, accordingly, because, again, I'm going to need it for Starbirth. Starbirth will be very important to find, like, Leon Choice Belt or Cheryl or the Aggron. Oh, they do play Choice Belt. They aren't getting Cheryl here. No, they had Cheryl. That's their third Cheryl, though. They have one left. Maybe I'll Cracking Stomp it away. Being a Cheryl, I might have to Cheryl this turn, because they are doing 170. They have Quick Shooting for next turn, too. Oh, this is bad. Can't one-shot because I don't have enough energy built up either. Nice. That was a huge draw. That was a really good draw. So how much HP do I have? 190. They're doing 170 with G-Max, Spiral, plus one quick shooting would knock me out. And they probably have... Yeah, they could just go Rapid Strike, Surge, or Inteleon. But I guess I have the Cheryl here. All right, here's what we'll do. Grab Arceus. Either I take the big one at KO with Aggron, which would be the ideal play. So I'm going to go Crobat first. No, I'm going to get it, though, with only a Metal Saucer. No, I can't take the one at KO. If I go double Turbo Energy, I do 250 Choice Belt. Nah, damn it. Maybe I have to get rid of the Bronzong, then. So I can... I don't have Crobat in the deck. Never mind, the Crobat is prized. I didn't know that. I should have known that. I guess we're just gonna have the Starbirth for Cheryl plus research. Damn. So I'm not gonna be able to get this one at KO. So they Cheryl again. We're gonna have to deal with that again. Oh my god. Alright, well, that's annoying. That should be their last Cheryl, though, because we did get lucky. Or maybe, you know what? If they don't have Cheryl in their hand, we can Cracking Stomp and get rid of it. Or we can maybe hit, like, an Inteleon, and maybe they prize her their Inteleon. It'd be pretty good. Oh, that sucks. The Choice Belt is so bad for us. I was kind of hoping they weren't playing it, to be honest, but whatever. Getting no energy in play this turn is also pretty bad, but we got Cheryl or research for next turn. Maybe they'll Marnie me, too. They could Marnie me into, like, a really good hand. I don't know. Cracking Stomp. Hit Cheryl, please. Cheryl or Drizzle or Quick Shooting or something. Just any way to get rid of their Cheryl. Oh! Back to back, we hit the Cheryl and the Inteleon. Hey, let's go. We hit the Quick Shooting. Maybe they can't two-shot me. They can two-shot me. But hopefully they don't have Shady Dealings. We did get rid of their Inteleon there. Both Inteleons are in the discard, right? So, like, they don't have Shady Dealings Intel, so they have to have a Drizzle here to Cheryl. If they don't Cheryl, that's really good. I can G-Max Takedown, knock them out. Hmm. Or ideally, I knock him out with Arceus V-Star, which would be the better play to do. All right, we'll see. Just no Cheryl, please, don't do it. Unless they... yeah, no Cheryl. I can't knock him out in one hit. I can't KO them, bro. And they scoop. Hey, let's go. You know what? Aggron put in a lot of work, bro. We had some... one would say we had some cracking stomps. All right. See if we can win the coin flip here. We do. Ooh, okay. We'll take it. Now, we'll see what we're playing against, and hopefully we can beat him. We get an Aggron start. We can actually go for a turn 2 Aggron here, which I am going to do. We can put double turbo energy on and use Aggron V's, Aggron VMAX. Ooh, but they open up a Whimsicott. That's fine. Okay. I'm going to quick ball here, away the boss. Actually, I probably could have got rid of Metal Saucer, but we are going to go straight for the Arceus because we do have the V-Star in our hand. And then we can Ultra Ball here for the VMAX and then hopefully research into double turbo and I can save my Starbirth power for a rainy day. But yeah, we're up against Shadow Rider Whimsicott. That's going to be an interesting matchup for sure. I'm not too sure on that. We can one-shot the Shadow Rider though with Aggron. Aggron can also one-shot Whimsicott, so I guess it's not too bad. It's a good thing they didn't Shadow Miss me here. Actually, might not have been a bad play for my opponent to do that, to be honest. Because I wouldn't have been able to do anything. I wouldn't even have been able to do, like, my Trini Charge. I don't have, like, a Bronzong established. So, like, yeah, it's a good thing they're doing Fluff Gets in the Way. That's a very funny attack. What the heck? Okay, hopefully they don't get too many Shadow Riders down here. Just two, hopefully, is all they get. Nah, they get a Zacian. Actually, it's good if they don't attack me here. The more HP, the better. Because, I mean, we have 330 HP, which is pretty bulky. Especially against Shadow Rider. So, hopefully they don't attack me here. Probably just going to do Roar the Sword. We'll see, though. We'll see. No, they do attack me. Okay. I don't know why they bench the Zacian then. Because they speak to Metal. No, I drew my Cheryl. Oh, that's a pretty rough draw. I'm not going to lie. I got to... Not much I can do about that. That's a pretty bad... I probably could have just went Starbirth. But... And then kept the Cheryl. I could have went, like, Starbirth for Turbo Marnie. But whatever. Yeah, that was a pretty bad research. Jeez. Wasn't a bad research per se, but it was kind of mid. I do have to Starbirth for my double turbo. It's something I didn't want to do, but looks like I'm gonna have to. Get the double turbo RNG in play too before the they kind of lock me. Now, do I play the Crystal Cave here? Yeah, I actually don't mind getting Crystal Cave here. I can heal the damage they did to me. Yeah, sure. Why not? I don't think it matters, but it's fine. We'll do it. We'll heal. And then we can Cracking Stomp for the knockout because they're weak to metal. And we discard the top card of their deck, which is an Adventure Scarf. That's a really good discard. That's a great discard. Now they can't get like two Shadow Riders for free. I don't know if that'll matter too much, but that was a pretty decent discard. And then we just kind of work towards our play. I might boss the Shadow Rider they try to build up, and then we can try to slam with Aggron. It is pretty bad, though. I did lose my Cheryl, though. That is a very big discard. I'm not going to lie. Not having Cheryl anymore is bad. I honestly kind of want to play two in the deck. I don't know what you would cut, though, but two Cheryls might actually be the way to go with this deck. I just don't know what to cut. You know, actually, you know what? No, I can just win by KOing Zacian and KOing Kerbal. They gave me the opportunity to just go boss, boss, boss. I think that actually just might be the win con then, right? We only have one boss, though, don't we? I can't knock out Crobat with Aggron this turn. I might be able to go Arceus, but I need to keep the boss. I can knock out with Arceus next turn if I get a switch. Then Omarni me. I can go Bronzong, find switch. Because, I mean, literally, we could win by just taking knockouts with Cracking Stomp on the Zacian. I can knock out Crobat and Zacian to win the game. Might actually be a potential win con. Because that Whimsicott just happened to be weak to metal. You know, it just kind of gets cracked in the face by Cracking Stomp. All right, let's see if they have anything here. They have a one-card hand now. Do they have a supporter, or are they stuck in top deck mode? Did my Cracking Stomp do justice? Because, again, the Adventure Discovery is a good discard, because, you know, they could have went triple Shadow Rider with that. I want to kill the Crobat here if I can, but at the same time, I don't want to Marnie them. They don't have anything. All right. So I could just hit them again with Aggron. I could boss a Shadow Rider. I don't know. I really want to try to attack with Arceus V-Star here. Okay, if I KO their Crobat, I literally set the win by KOing Zacian. The problem is, I don't know if it's worth it to Marnie their one-card hand. Because if they're in top deck mode, it just feels so bad. Wish I played three boss. If I whip the switch off the Marnie, that's just really bad. I kind of want to... Honestly, I'm tempted just to boss the Shadow Rider. We still have to go through more, though. Shoot. I think we honestly have to try to kill the Crobat here. I'm thinking about it. I think we have to try to go for this KO on the Crobat. I have two Switch in the deck. Hopefully I find it. I don't know what else would be good here. Zacian maybe? It's a nice strong attacker. I could get another Aggron. No, I already have one in play. Get Zamazenta for now, I guess. Fine. And then we'll research. Losing my boss? I don't know. Can we get Switch? We do. Okay, good. So yeah, I can KO the Crobat here with Aggron. Or with Aggron. With Arceus. And this actually does open the door now for me to Oko the Shadow Rider at some point. So we'll see how that goes. Let's go Trini Nova. Take out the Crobat. Take out three energy here. Put him on Aggron. Speaking of Aggron, what am I getting my other VMAX with the prizes here? I probably should have saved the choice belt, though, because, well, I don't know. Because the turbo energy kind of messes our math up a little bit. Okay, Crystal Cave is good. There we go. Okay. So I could try to go Aggron VMAX KO the Shadow Rider. But they're in a pretty bad spot right now. I think we got him. We can always threaten the play to max takedown. The only issue is I have no Gust left. I don't think I have a third boss, so I'm not going to be able to kill that Zacian. Now, funny enough, if I actually Marnie there, I think I would have gotten the Switch. So, I guess maybe if I did play Marnie, I could have gotten the Switch after all. But again, I'm not trying to give more cards. Speaking of Marnie, they're going to Marnie me, which is fine. Our hand actually was not great because we didn't have a supporter. Let's see if we can get it here. Nope. That's not good. That's not good. I got a training court. Do I have energy in the discard? I don't. Okay. Can they KO me here? I don't think so. Again, not having boss is going to be a big deal for sure. It's going to make this a bit harder to win. Going for another Whimsicott. They can't really use Whimsicott anymore. It's just kind of... it's a bad attacker. It's weak to metal. It gets absolutely slain by the Aggron. I don't know. And this might be tough to kind of take this last knockout, depending on how it goes. They play a Lumineon down. They played that a little too early, and they should have waited. I mean, I'm not going to Marnie them because I am top decking. I'm in top deck mode, but we'll see. I always do Zacian's ability, or Zamazenta, sorry. Seems bad. They're getting boss. I think after my Aggron next turn. Okay, that's fine. They're not KO my active. I can just build the other Aggron. I can spread out the energy a little bit. I mean, they KO this thing, right? I don't want to have a double turbo energy on it. Because I do want to do that big damage push. I can hold the Lumineon plate too. We drew a Marnie. Oh, you know what I could do? Marnie them in return. Can I win this turn? No, because I have the double turbo energy. I could balloon here into Aggron. And then I can cracking stomp them. And just go into the other... they go into the other Shadow Rider. But if I do go this play, they might not be able to knock out my Aggron. They did 160... I could do 190, 220, 250. They get 4 energy in play next turn. They could do like 280. They can't knock out my Aggron next turn. I just don't have Cheryl anymore. But I could feed them the Aggron and force them to gust me here. Or I could just attack them and build up more energy. I feel like that's probably the safer play, in all honesty. It's just kind of build up more energy here. I'm just going to build up more energy. That's fine. We need to get... yeah, we need to get energy in play. So I'm just going to build up more energy here. They might boss knock out my Aggron V, but I don't think that really does anything for my opponent. I could have Ultra Balled for the Lumineon... or for the Aggron VMAX, but I didn't want to Quick Ball. I didn't want to Ultra Ball away the Balloon or the Choice Belt. So I don't know. I wanted to keep it. I probably should have Ultra Balled, though, away the Air Balloon and the Arceus, though. For the Aggron VMAX. I guess I don't want them to KO me. I guess if they do knock me out, it's a little sus, but... I mean, I still have my Saucers, right? So the thing is, so they're going to go in the other Shadow Rider. I'm just trying to make sure I can one-shot them. Which I can do next turn if I can pull off the combo. We'll see. I just need to find Leon plus Aggron VMAX. And I can KO this. I don't know. Maybe I should have went for that play. They are going to get Whimsicott here. Again, they can never attack me with it because it is weak to metal. If only I had a boss. If I still had a boss left, I would have been fine. I don't want to play Eldegoss in this deck. Honestly, maybe that's better than the second Cheryl is Eldegoss. Eldegoss might actually be a good include in this deck. I don't know what I would cut, but honestly, I'm thinking about Eldegoss. That actually might just be good in here to get back Cheryl and Leon. If I had Eldegoss, I could just Cheryl. Yeah, we definitely want to play Eldegoss. I don't think we're going to lose or anything at this point, but we'll see. I can still have a Revenge Blast KO, potentially. If they take 5 prizes, I can do quite a bit of damage. plus choice bow. Actually, I think that might just be 310, but I have Leon plus choice bow for Sam. We'll see. There's boss. They're going to go after my VMAX. They don't have a knockout, though. But I can't knock them out. Well, maybe. If I draw Lumineon or Leon or Aggron VMAX here, I think I have game. I can hard retreat and still have enough energy for the other Aggron. I think I actually can still win the game. I think I have my other Aggron in my deck. I'm pretty sure I got off the prizes. Okay, how much are they doing? 250? Only I had think. The big thing is... Oh, we just win. I just realized they didn't even switch. I just win. All right, let's get it. All right, they didn't even switch. All right, G-Max takedown. We'll take it. Yeah, I just realized. My opponent didn't even play a switch there. They just stayed in the active and let me knock them out. All right, we'll take it. The dubs with Aggron. That was a bit of a hairy game because of the... what's his face? Because of... The boss's order is being discarded. Definitely, I think an Eldegoss is a great include in this deck, though, to be honest. Anyways, that'll wrap the video, guys, on the Aggron VMAX Arceus deck, I think, with those games. It's a pretty cool deck. Honestly, it wasn't bad at all. I definitely think you want to maybe play the Eldegoss in the deck, like I said. Again, getting back Cheryl and the boss is good. So I definitely think you could play an Eldegoss in here, though. I really don't know what you would cut out of the deck. Like, I guess you could cut the Manaphy out. And just kind of have to take the Elder Urshifu, but I feel like you need it. I honestly don't think there's much you can really cut. I guess you could go down to like two Aggron V. You could go down to like two Aggron V for like an Eldegoss, honestly, isn't a terrible idea. Because I do think Eldegoss would be a pretty good include in this deck overall. But yeah, Aggron VMAX is pretty sick. I think both attacks are pretty solid. Cracking Snob was kind of cool. We got some pretty cool moments with that. And we also have G-Max Takedown, which is pretty good too. So anyways, that'll wrap the video, guys, on Aggron VMAX. Let me know what you guys thought of the video in the comments below. And of course, if you guys enjoyed the video, leave a like in the video, subscribe down below. Help me on reaching 25,000 subs. At the time of recording this, we are not quite at 25k subs. If you have not subbed to the channel yet, hit that subscribe button right now. And if you're watching this when I already have 25k subs, subscribe, help me reach 26k subscribers. Check out Card Cabin down below. If you're gonna get any codes, use my discount code ColdLeaf. Check out my Twitch, my Twitter, my Discord server, and I'll catch you guys later. Bye-bye.